I am going to tell you the most efficient way to count the maximum number of consecutive ones in a binary number right now. Hey everyone, I am Kanahaiya Gupta. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's start. So this is the given binary string, and that we have different sequences of 1. So first sequence has number of ones equals to 2. And the second sequence has number of ones equals to 3. The third sequence has number of 1 equals to 4. So among all these, the answer is 4. Because we need to return the maximum number of consecutive ones, which is 4. So this is the problem, guys. Now we'll see how we are going to solve this problem. I have taken the number, which is a 211184, it's an integer number, and this is a binary representation of this number, and these boxes represent the number of ones for each sequence. So I have highlighted with the same color. You can see this sequence contains 1, 2 times, so it shows the 2. This second sequence shows 3 ones, so it's represented by 3, and the third sequence having 4 ones is represented by 4. So first we'll take this binary number, and in the next step we are going to calculate the left shift of this binary number. So we'll perform a left shift operation on this number. So once you perform a left shift this number, so you can see the whole string is shifted by 1, and after that if you'll do AND operation of both of these two, you will get this number. So you can see, guys, in initial string we have count of ones 2, and second sequence has 3, and the third sequence has 4. But after performing this operation, the first sequence has 1, second sequence has 2, and third sequence has 3. So in each sequence it's reduced by 1. And the same is updated over here. So after applying this operation, each sequence is reduced by 1. So now perform the same step again. So this time number will be this, and we have calculated the left shift, and again perform the AND operation. So after this AND operation, again we can see each sequence is reduced by 1. The same is updated over here. So like that, if you perform the same operation again and again, we can see finally all become 0. So now we don't need to perform this operation anymore, because there's no ones. If you perform this operation, it doesn't make any sense. We have to perform this operation till we get 0. And each step is a counter, because every step we are reducing 1 from every sequences. If we have 4 ones, so you can see there will be 4 steps, because this is the maximum number of ones, and this one will be there till the end. If you see the steps, like we have 2 ones, right? So after 2 steps, this will not be there. So first step introduced to 1, and the second step, after performing the second step, it's gone. So like that, this sequence has 3 ones. So once you perform one step, so it reduced to 2, then you perform next step, it reduced to 1, and after this 3 step, it's no more. So like that, so the longer sequence will stick up till the end, and we have to calculate the length of longest sequence, or you can say we have to calculate the maximum number of ones. So it's nothing, is the same thing, just counting the steps, or you can say instead of steps you can say it's a count. So for each steps we are maintaining a count and increasing that. So till the end, once it's 0, we'll see how many steps and counts are there. 4. So it means 4 is the answer. I hope, guys, it's clear to you. Let's see how we are going to write the logic for it. So this is the method, guys, count consecutive ones in a binary, and that I am assuming we'll get the integer number. Once you get the integer number, I'm just taking a variable count, which will hold the count of the maximum consecutive ones. And this is a while loop. And this while loop will keep on running until the number is greater than 0. So just now we have seen, we have to perform those steps until the number is greater than 0. Once it's 0, we'll stop it. And the main step which we are going to perform is this. We'll take the number, and after that we'll do the end operation of the number with the left shift. And whatever the result will come, we'll store into a number, and this number is updated with the new result. And the same operation we have to keep on follow until the number is greater than 0. And each step we will count how many steps has been performed. So for that we are maintaining a count, and we are keep on increasing this count based on the steps, how many steps has been done. And this count represent the number of consecutive ones, as we have already discussed, because the longest the length of the one, or you can say the longest the length of the sequence of one, the counter will keep on incrementing, and it will hold the number of ones, and after that we can return the count. Let's try to analyze this algorithm, guys. So this is the same example which we have seen. So in that, we know the everything here, it depends on the number of ones. But among all sequences, it depends on the number of maximum number of ones. If there are four consecutive ones, we are going to perform four steps, because after the four step, everything will be zero. And the steps, you can see only the green consecutive ones exist till the end, because this is the longest string or longest consecutive one inside a string. So the total number of count is directly proportional to the longest string, or we can say the total number of count is directly proportional to the longest consecutive sequence. So based on that, we can easily say the time complexity of this algorithm is OK, where k is the length of maximum consecutive one, and the space complexity is O1, because we have not used any extra space over here. I hope, guys, this problem is clear to you, and this question has been asked in many interviews, as well as it's also given in a HackerRank platform. So you can go and try this question on HackerRank also. If you have any problem in solving this, you can check out my source code, which is present in the GitHub, and let me know how many marks you got in a HackerRank platform after solving this. Thanks for watching, guys.